Hello everyone, welcome to part, what is it now, 10? Yes, 10 of the Cliffview project. Now, I neglected to start the screen recorder when I started the part, which is why we're joining this already in progress. But what I did was just a bunch of boring stuff over here as I extended my road grid around here. And I extended the commercial area and I added an office area, then I added a large residential area below it. So I'll get the city running again. I'll speed it up so that things can happen faster. As the residential area fills in, the lack of jobs, zots there should disappear. Depending how fast it fills in, they might disappear before the buildings abandon. Now, obviously, I only have two roads into the area, and that could be problematic. I'm actually going to replace this connection with a straighter road. So I can take this out. Anyway, as you can see, there isn't a lot of road connections in and out of here, and that will likely be problematic in the future, but it should be okay for now, as I expect most of the workers will end up working up here. Ultimately, I'm going to have an access point over here. What I'm going to do while I'm waiting for everything to develop there is I'm going to set up an alignment for the highway here. I figure it'll line up about there with that gap. Okay, so that means it doesn't quite line up there, actually. So that's about where it will line up with that gap. Okay, good. So that's where I'll just leave that for now. I'll change that to an actual highway later. But that gives me a temporary access point there as well, which may help with traffic. Actually, I'll upgrade the main road itself to a highway here. Okay. So that gives me an alternative access point into there. So that may reduce some of the traffic some on that other roundabout. I may need to replace that roundabout interchange with something else, a more tailor-made operation, which will give me a big mess like on the other side of the river. I don't know if you remember that setup over here with all this mess here, but that mess flows pretty well, so I can't say that that's necessarily bad. I see this stuff is flowing fairly well. Okay, so I don't have a major traffic problem brewing. So, nice thing about Skylines, if I wanted to, I could build an interchange hanging out totally over the water, like this intersection here. Okay, so it's filling in over here. And you can see that I don't have the lack of worker zots here anymore. That's good. I'm getting to the point where I'm probably going to want to acquire land over in this direction. Not sure. I'll have to think about that. I'm going to pause this and replace this ridiculous construction I've got going on here with a single roadway bridge. Okay. Okay, yeah, that should be all I need. Take off that. Okay. Okay, that just looks better. And it doesn't really need the extra scheme there. But this also means I can come along and build another solar installation right there. Which also means I can get rid of some of these. While I'm doing that, I'm going to turn on the electrical overlay to make sure I don't cause myself trouble here. Do I have... Okay, I do have an electrical bridge there, so I'm good. One of the nice things about Skylines over SimCity 4 is apparently the Sims are smart enough to do maintenance on their buildings, so you don't have to replace them due to old age. Which I always thought was dumb in SimCity 4, since any real installation, you'd actually be going ahead and repairing it. You wouldn't be replacing it. It would be part of the general operation of the thing to replace anything that needs replacing. Now, I'm getting rid of these... come on. These windmills, because they create noise pollution, and they're generally less than... less than nice to... the land value, you saw when I demolished them, these bits upgraded immediately. And the solar plants generate quite a lot of power without having a lot of separate installations. I'm going to need to have another one somewhere, say here, to meet the needs when I take the rest of these out, though. Anyway, here we go. There we go. That gets rid of one bit that takes up well, both simulation resources and space. Okay, that does seem to have increased my frame rate a bit. Probably because there's less objects that have to be animated. I'm also going to make a change in the highway here. I talked about it previously. Whoops, I want roads and highway. But I want to elevate it through here up to... Well, actually, I can elevate it right up to here. And this ramp can connect elevated. Okay, so I'm going to remove the highway and that part of that ramp. And this ramp. Okay. 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 That's good. Now I'll bring my ramp off here. Okay. So that's elevated now, which means I should be able to get a road under that. Let's see what I can get under there. I'm going to try a straight road initially. Okay, come on, there we go. Nope, that doesn't, oh! I can get a straight road under there. If I turn off snapping to the grid. There we go, I can get a road under there. Can I get a road under here? Only on an angle. Ooh. I can get another road under there. Okay. I think that's a good thing. So I'm going to bring this road across nice and straight up to there, nice and straight, and link up. And I'm going to bring the... Ooh, I made it to a colossal city. Next up is a metropolis at 60,000. Okay, so I'm going to bring my road across to there. Oh. I'm going to bring this road across to there, and then one more. And then I'm going to go straight up like that and link up. Okay. Can I get that road across? Ooh. I can. And I can make another link up like that. Okay. So that will give me some additional road connection options between the areas. So that should be good. Okay, so I can speed that up again. Oh, and now I've got traffic going there, so that should take some pressure off over here. And I can, in theory, make some interchangey stuff over here in the future. I'm not sure what I'll do, but I probably will make some interchangey stuff. I might actually have enough room to build a diamond with one direction of it in the middle. which could be interesting. What this kind of does too is it makes the university over here more available to the residential I've just created over here. So far so good there. Okay, so I've got these incinerators over here that are making pollution, so I'm not sure what I'm going to do about those. What I am going to do, first I'm going to check, okay, water should be good across the top there. So I'm going to put some more office zoning up here. Since there is demand for that sort of thing. And I'm going to make commercial down to here. Actually, I won't zone that chunk, as I'm going to need something there for interchangey stuff. Okay. Now, clearly, I have some more land I can come this way with this. This is where I'm encountering the out-of-sync grid, so exactly what I do there is up in the air still. Can this one come through at all? It doesn't go through there. It runs into something. What's the space already occupied by? Okay. What if I curve that? Will that go? Nope. Ah. Okay. Well, if I come straight out here, I can go across like that. Okay. Let's curve this some more. There we go. That gets me under the highway. Now, that's about where the road would be. So there's my grid road. And I can link up there. And I can link up like that. Okay. And my grid can continue. Oops, that's not right. Okay, 4. Okay, that's better. Like so. Like so. And this one links up like so. And like so. And this one can also link up. Okay. So far, so good. Now I'll bring this one across. Nope. Like so. This is a lot of what you missed when I forgot to start the recording. a bunch of grid building, so I don't think anyone's going to be too overly broken up about it. I could have stopped what I was doing, gone back to a previous save point, but I didn't think that was going to be particularly it wasn't going to be worth it just to show you a bunch of boring stuff I did. Okay, so I can't do that. Okay, so I've dealt with the grids coming together here. Okay, so I'm good there. Not sure what I'm going to fill that in with. But I'm going to finish off the grid stuff here. By doing this. And one more. It's pretty clear that I didn't get my grid pattern lined up with the city limit, but I wasn't even really trying to. At some point, I'm going to have to consider some transit here. But for the moment, as long as traffic is fine, I'm going to leave that alone. Okay, so that's basically the area has now has a grid. Okay, so I'm not sure exactly what I should do here, but I'm going to put offices right against the highway and in this weird area here. Okay, well, obviously it's going to need water. Duh. Okay. We. Okay. We. Okay. And I'm going to need another water pipe up here and down here and one over here. Okay. Now, over here, I just need to extend these ones. There is a school of thought that says that this water pipe stuff is a little bit excessive, and I do tend to agree a bit with that sentiment. The way SimCity, what was it, SimCity 2000 did water pipes is you would plant the mains and the buildings would contain have distribution pipes underneath them. and those pipes would link up with neighboring buildings. So you could have all the water you needed distributed solely by the pipes built under buildings. Now, when the buildings were demolished, pipes didn't necessarily go away, which meant that you know, you could have a fairly complete water system without having a huge network of water mains. Now, I think theoretically the water mains were a little bit higher capacity, but I don't think that they even, you know, like you had that notion that they might be, but I don't think the developers really thought about it that way, so I don't know that it was necessarily implemented. Okay, so that gets me my water back capabilities back up where they need to be. And it's kind of good that I caught it this time before it was a crisis. You know, that could have been bad otherwise. I'm going to zone some commercial again over here. I'm going to put a small commercial area right here too. And I'm going to distribute some parks here. I'm probably going to really need to look into public transit in this area soon. Well, that's not where I want it. If you're wondering why I didn't just move it, that was actually less convenient than bulldozing it in the first place. Okay. That should make the areas happier. Now, I'll take a look at fire coverage looks good. So does police coverage. So I'm going to leave those alone. Education for elementary school is iffy. So I'll put a couple of those in. And high school is iffy over here. So I'll put one of those in. And I'll put one over here. Now, having an overabundance of schools, as long as you can afford it in your budget, is not a problem. And then when it comes down to when you need to, when you increase the density, then you start to, I need to deal with the possibility of trash here. So I think I'll install a new incinerator. Maybe two of them. That's out of the city limit, so I'm clearly not doing it there, but I can do one there. Okay. Why are those black? Come on. So how's the not operating? Okay, that one's just come online. And that one's just come on. Okay. So that should sort out any trash that I might be producing. So over here, have some people living. And all along the bottom here, I'll have some people living. I'm specifically not building bigger roads here because I don't want the traffic to be fast going through here. I don't want through traffic, and the Sims will take the faster roads, so that will tend to work better. Okay, so I don't have a huge demand for residential, but at some point it's going to fill in. That will, basically set things up. Now, I really should build my ramp system here. Now, what I'm going to do is set up short one-way road stubs here. Now, the reason I'm going to do that is it should eliminate any traffic lights that get created by the road connections. Okay. Okay, that'll do for now. Okay, so what I really need to do is elevate the highway here. So that means I need to demolish a bit of it and rebuild it. This actually, if I snap to the grid, I should be able to get it where I want it. Okay, so that's one direction. Okay, so I can demolish this and it shouldn't stop the traffic flow. Okay, so I'm going to do the same thing again. This time I can stop it on that side. Okay. And okay, now I need to get the road going in the right direction. Okay, so now I have an interchange there. It's relatively low capacity, but it should function. Now, got some funkiness going here. Oh, I see what I did there. I went too high on that one. Okay. I'll try building that again. Okay. Okay, that should be a little more symmetrical. Yes, that looks better. Good. Okay, so far so good. Generally, I'm feeling fairly good about how this city's developing. I've got basically the urban sprawl thing going on here, and I'm not particularly unhappy about that, actually. It's kind of what I was going for in this particular project. I've got the dense core here, and I've got the stuff spreading out on the outskirts. Now, I don't expect that a lot of this stuff will get filled in. What have I got here? Low land value. Why do I have a low land value there? Well, let's take a look here. Well, it's not due to the park there. It must be something else. Okay, so I'm going to take a look at noise pollution. I don't have noise pollution there. I don't have pollution there. What's the death care? That looks okay. School coverage is weak. What if I put one of these over here? Well, that's certainly improving the levels in the area. I don't know why that's low land value there, but it is, and I guess it is what it is, so I'll leave it at that. This is probably going to stay the way it is for a while. Not sure quite what to do about that. I see I've got demand for residential is growing. It is low land value just there. I don't get it. Well, no, it's not. Well, yeah, it is. But why? Maybe it's, well, it's not transit coverage. Crime? No. Well, where are my police stations? Maybe that's what it is. Is that it? Land value. That might have been it. Okay, well, I'll put a fire station in too. That was a small one. Okay. Yeah, that might help. Now, let's see what land value has to say. Well, it's improved. Okay. Okay, demographics, I have low unemployment. I have a death wave here, so that's going to be a problem briefly. Okay, so I'm going to undo that. Now I'm going to look here and see what I want to do for land purchase. Now what do I want to do? That one, yeah. That one, yeah. That one has the rail connection. I'm going to buy that one. And that one. Okay. This one, and that's it for now. Okay. Okay, so I've expanded the city limits here, so that'll allow me to do something next time around. I'm not sure whether I'm going to connect anything to the rail. I might do a tourist connection on the rail line. Bring the metro down around this way and make a connection. Yeah, that might be a good thing to do. Make a tourist connection. Okay. Not sure though. I'm not going to do that this part, because that's a fairly big time investment to get running. So I'll hold on that. Now let's see what this the traffic's doing in this monstrosity interchange thingy here. It's getting used. Not every ramp, but it is getting used. So, you know, I don't think I can complain about that. Well, that's a slightly warped clover stack. And it is working. I see I've got a traffic snarl building here in this roundabout affair here. So I may need to reconstruct that. That might be a project for the next part, but I'm largely going to leave it alone for now. Because while it is busy, it does seem to be flowing, so I think, in general, it's not actually a problem. Although, strangely enough, it might work better as... I might need to build some ramps around there. Those are two lane roads there. Okay. Thank you. I'm going to, just for giggles here, I'm going to expand this ramp. Well, that's fun. Got some issues with the zones not disappearing there. Might be due to these mods I have in. Right. Okay, I'm going to widen this one in as well, and this one out. Okay, so that means that I won't bottleneck as bad on the highway merges. I wonder if that will help there. Yeah, it might. And maybe expanding this one will help too, so I'll do that. At the very least, I get faster roads there. Well, that might actually just solve my traffic problem. It just might. Can't. Ooh, I can bring that in with the three lanes there. Yeah, if I take the zoning out there, that might improve things. Oh, to do that right, I should use the flood fill thing. Take the zoning off of here, too. Okay. I'm gonna move this over to, come on. Why can't I place it on that roadside? Well, actually, I don't need that one. I'll replace it with one here. Now, okay, that needs to go away. And expand that and that. Okay. So that should improve the capacity there with the ramps. And for pity's sake, there's a clear bug there with the de-zoning. Well, what if I zone it? Okay. And that's kind of dumb. Okay. There. I think that solved the traffic bottleneck on that roundabout. At least for the moment. Okay, so And it's flowing better anyway, so I'll leave it as that. Why are there no zones along there? Okay. Let's see if we can fix that. No. No zones. Why are there no zones there? Well, I'm going to pause it. And rebuild that road. Now I have zones along there. Okay. Okay, so that's better. Oh, I think I know what it was. I had a pedestrian path in there. Right. And that was here. Okay. Okay, so now I've got a path across there again. That should improve things. Well, certainly the pedestrians are using it. That's good. So, yeah. Okay. Fill in that gap there. Okay. Good. Oh, I could fill in that gap too. Okay. Yeah. Good. So I'm up to 41,000 residents in my city. I'm going to take a look in. Yeah, the land value problem is sorted out over there now. Okay, good. I've got lower land values over here, though. Demographics, the seniors' population percentage is down. That's good. Birth rates turned around, so I've ridden out that particular death wave. Power's good for now. Water's good. Health coverage is good. Death care is good. Noise pollution isn't too bad. Obviously, it's on the main roads is noisy. Pollution itself isn't too bad. Yeah, that's not bad at all. It's clustered around the dirty stuff. Fire safety's reasonable. Crime rate's reasonable. Let's take a look in the metro line. I'm actually. I could probably make that work better if I built it into a full circle, or built another one across. But, and if I had maybe another stop or two along here. Buses, they're doing reasonable. Okay, so that's not so bad. Outside connections, imports. I'm actually exporting goods. Interesting. Total imports. Yeah, I can live with that. I have relatively few tourists. So that might build the train station, passenger train station, to bring some of those in. Resources. Yeah. I might actually build a farming area on top of the cliff here. Just for fun. Right. Maybe I should build some unique buildings or something too. Anyway. So this is the city currently. You can see it's fairly spread out, but not too bad. It's only, what, 4 or 5 kilometers across, so it's that's not bad. Okay, so I'm not sure. Next time around, I might do something over here. Because I can't really get up onto here until I pick up this tile and possibly this one. Well, I can, because I do have the highway into there, but realistically, I probably won't do anything with it, because this is the only reasonable transportation link up there. Okay, on the upside, I don't have to build it. Okay, good. I might actually come over and work over here too. Anyway, I'm up to 42,000 citizens. So I'm going to save the game here. And no crash. Okay, so that's the end of part 10, I believe it is. Yep, of my Cliffview project. I'll see everyone back for part 11. Thank you for watching.